Hey everybody, my name's Chris. Welcome to Casual Fragrances. I'm here with my girlfriend Kelly.
Hey.
So if you like fragrance related content, make sure you show your support by the end of this video by clicking that red subscribe button down below. I really appreciate that. And make sure you like the videos, like this type of content, and make sure you click the bell icon so you don't miss future videos like this and giveaway videos as well. Before the video starts, we are going to announce the two giveaway winners for a video I did a couple days ago. It is for Nelson and Wilson. This is Bonavir by Mr. Smelly. I have two 4 mil decans I have here. I'm announced the two winners for this right here. I'm gonna leave my email information down below. Definitely email me so I can get your product out to you. Like I said, in every giveaway, I'll give you 1 week to respond back to me. After that, I can't send it out to you because I work and I do a lot of giveaways. I can't keep track. I mean, you guys can come back and tune in and see if you won or not. So I try to do it at the beginning of the video so you can see if you won or not instead of waiting to the end. First winner for a sample of this is called Perry Nelson 777. I'm gonna leave his comment right here in the front so you can see it. And the second winner is Mark Bell. Okay, so I'm gonna leave both the comments here. Definitely reach out to me in about
easy
a week.
Usernames this
yeah,
time.
Really easy names. Reach out to me about a week. Leave an email down below, and I'll get your product out to you in a couple of days. I'll try to ship it out on a weekend because I have them days off of work. Nevertheless, you will get your package as long as you email me your information and your USA only giveaway winner. So congratulations to the winners. Today we're talking about new release from the house of Zaharoff. Okay, so before the video starts, me and Kelly met George in 2019 at Scent Explorer. Awesome guy, very nice, polite, talked to. Took time to talk to us about fragrances and such. So much stuff he's coming out with, new stuff.
Feels like that was like 4 years ago.
Yeah, it felt forever. Yeah, with the pandemic, I haven't seen George. But real nice guy. I asked for a sample, I think it was in 2018, to try out Zaharoff Signature Perfume. He was nice enough to send me a bottle to say, try it out. If you like it, you don't. You know, I was like, oh, cool. Like, I didn't want no bottle. I wanted a little sample. He was nice to give me a bottle to review it. And to this day, I appreciate George. He didn't have to do that for me. You know, I just want a little sample, and if I like it, I'll bought the bottle, and it smells amazing. Then two more other flankers came out. Now we have a new release here. This is called Zaharoff Signature Rose. So the bottle's here. My girlfriend has the box there. Every one of the presentations are really beautiful. I have to touch on that for a second. They're beautiful presentations.
I match this fragrance right now.
Yeah.
With my lipstick and my hair.
Which is pretty cool, so the bottle matches it. In this video, I'm gonna break down how it performs on my skin, the price point, scenes and occasions, and my ratings and my girlfriend's ratings and thoughts, so stay tuned. This fragrance here, I'll zoom in the camera, you can see it, goes for about $145 for a 60 ml bottle. If you don't wanna buy the bottle at once, you can actually do a payment plan. It's called Shop Pay through Samsung. So pretty much is you put like $36 down to start, and then every 2 weeks they take another $36, like four payments, so you can pay it off. So
I've done stuff.
It's not
like
bad,
that.
And there's no interest on it. So they just basically take it out of your checking account or your debit card. It's not bad.
Yeah, I think it works. Like I've done that with like a couple like other like Afterpay. If you
yeah, that's
Afterpay
or something like that. But it's Samsung Pay. But it's something nice if you want to buy it and you just can't dish out $145
at
one point. But you can break it down in weeks when you get paid every 2 weeks. That's all. I'm not saying you should do that. I'm saying is whatever one works for you better financially, do what you want to do. I'm not saying do one or the other.
I think that's nice that he offers that.
That's pretty cool. Something different. You can get the fragrance and just pay monthly for it. So it's not like you have to dish out $145 in one shot plus tax.
Mm-hmm.
Ladies and gentlemen, definitely I'll leave a link down below. Definitely go to the website, check it out. Okay, so I'm going to spray this, but before I spray it, I'm going to go over a note breakdown. Okay, so notes for this fragrance here are we have Turkish rose from Turkey. We have rose oat. We have the mid notes. We have gold amber, jasmine, red pinoy from China. And in the base, we have sandalwood, oud, myrrh, vanilla bean, abanum, slash frankincense, and we have sugar cane. Nevertheless, I'm gonna spray it on a card for Kelly, and I'm gonna spray it on another card for me. I've worn this three times so far now, and I'll let you know how I feel, but I like the beautiful presentation with the red and the cap. Kind of gives like a little touch to it with the name. It kind of fits the name and the theme of rose. The color like rose too, like.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Makes it stand out a little bit.
Yeah, it definitely does. So when it opens up, you do get that rose in there. So to me, it has like a fresh rose where it's rosy. And it's kind of like, I feel like a watery feel in the background. So it's kind of like a watery, fresh type of fragrance.
I wonder.
It's nice.
I feel like Saritha might really like this.
Okay. Might let our friend Saritha try it out. Shout out to Sreetha anyway. I got to bring her back on the channel hopefully the next couple weeks or month. I like it because it's a little bit different. Now, rose is not going to be for everybody. I understand that from fragrances, but this touch of rose is nice in this fragrance here. This is a heavy, prominent rose fragrance because of the name, but there is some oud in this fragrance as well, which gets into the fragrance later on in the mid and the dry down. And then you do get a sweetness in it. I'm not sure if it's coming from more of the amber or sugarcane, but there's a sweetness in it towards the dry down. But also primarily it's a lot of vanilla. Rose. There's vanilla too, so you get a sweetness. But this is primarily a rose scent. So like if you're thinking it's going to be vanilla balm or a sweet balm, this is a heavy, just rose in your face fragrance. Just rose. I mean, it's, let's be honest. The name is telling you what the fragrance is. I've worn it 3 times. And I enjoy the fragrance. It's something different because I'm not used to having a fragrance that primarily revolves around just rose. Mostly a lot of fragrance that bergamot, citruses. This was just like rose dominant. There is a freshness to this, but it's not citrus. I feel like it's just like a watery touch. We can touch some better on the performance right now. So projection for me, the first hour and a half is really strong. Like once I spray it, it's like, boom, it's out there. And then it does sit around your skin as a scent bubble for the next couple of hours, which isn't bad. So you can still smell it. And I've got between 7 to 8 hours on my skin with the longevity. So you might get more, but I got about 7 or 8. It's still there, but I feel like it's getting closer to the skin by that 7-8 hour mark. We have to dig your nose in to smell the fragrance. How do you feel about it?
I really like it. I'm not a big floral girl.
Okay.
You know, I'm a sweet girl. That sounded weird. You know what I mean. I like sweet fragrances. And I think because this does have, you said there was oud in here?
So there is oud in here too. I feel like it's not a heavy stinky oud. It's like It wells blended with the other notes where it's not like in your face. We're like, oh, because she smelled oud fragrances before and some of them can be good or be really bad or stinky, but this one seems to blend well with the rose.
I was like, you've really made me appreciate oud when done right. I mean, I think, you know, there's those stinky ouds, and yeah. I think for certain people, you know, to each their own. But like, I love golden oud, which I feel like is a really sweet oud. And I feel like this almost has that kind of sweet oud.
Yeah.
But I guess more so because of the rose, like a floral oud, I just feel like it's really well balanced. I really like the sweet after like tones with the vanilla and, I guess the sugar cane.
That's nice.
That I think brings a lovely balance to it. I think that's why I like this one better than I like most floral fragrances because of that. It brings in that sweetness that I like, but it's different, at least for me, because I don't, same thing, I am like, I'm not going to reach for a rose fragrance usually. Mm. Not that they're bad, I just, it's not my preferred, so this is a really nice change. Hello, Cleo. If you heard a little cry.
It's a cat. You heard both like oud for greatness too, that has oud in it as well. So it's like, it's one of the fragrances where the oud isn't stinky oud. Like the one fragrance is kind of strong, and Kelly smelled it before, it's from Christian Dior, it's the dude Oud Espahan. We smelled it in New York City. Some people might think it's barnyard oud, kind of stinky. This oud doesn't give you that vibe. That fragrance does 100%. But this one here is more, the oud is blended with the rose. It's not like it's a oud in your face.
Oud is a big turn off for you. Don't let that make you like go, oh, I can't, because I would not think that this has oud in it. Yeah. I was like, oh, that must be why it's so well balanced. Yeah.
You can pick it up in here, but it's not like in your face oud, like you want to put, you want to rub it off your skin. This is primarily a rose based fragrance from like the beginning, the middle, and the end. There's other notes like vanilla and the sugar cane gives a sweetness to it, but primarily this fragrance is focused on rose. So if you don't like the note of rose as a fragrance, you're probably not going to like this fragrance. So definitely do your research. Try to get a decant or a sample first off, but the name of the fragrance matches the juice and what it smells like. So there's not like you're not going to a fragrance where it's going to smell completely different than what the name is.
Correct.
Yeah. Seasons and occasions. Okay, so I feel like this could be a signature scent for a man or a woman. I know some people might think it more leans feminine because of the rose note.
Whenever
you know,
there's a floral, y'all think it's just so for ladies.
I think a girl or a guy could wear it. I think if you're a man and you're not afraid to wear a fragrance that has rose in it, it'd be a perfect scent. But some guys don't, so I understand that. So this is going to be a fragrance that you need to spray on your skin first. and see if it develops with your skin, because some rose fragrances can smell really good, some can smell very bad, depending on your skin chemistry. Mm-hmm. Definitely check that out, especially some of the other notes in it.
That's just true with all fragrances.
Yeah. I think spring, summer, fall, when you can wear this whenever you want. I feel like there's not really a bad time to wear rose. I would do maybe lesser sprays maybe in the summer, because it's hot.
Okay, I was like, I'll defer to you. Yeah. I was like, I can't really place this one.
So it's kind of hard, because I feel like you wear it anywhere. I feel like you just wear it. I feel like in the fall, you might want to do more sprays because it's colder outside. I mean, but in the summertime, I would maybe do one spray or two. But I would test it on yourself, on your own skin, and see how well it develops on your skin. If it performs poorly, then more sprays. If it performs like a champ, less sprays.
Very hard to see, but you know, he said like he's worn it like a couple days and he's barely put a dent in it, because he said, you know, it pushes quite a bit.
Yeah, you don't need many sprays with this fragrance. Unless your skin chemistry is not good, then obviously everybody's skin's different, but my skin, I don't need many sprays. Maybe three sprays tops, I'm good to go. Occasion wise, I feel like you can wear this dressed up or dressed down. I feel like it might shine more dressed up. I mean, maybe if you're going on a date, a dinner date with your girlfriend or significant other, you want to wear it to the office, you probably can wear it to the office. I don't think it's going to be offensive in the office, but I feel like lesser sprays. I feel like
it might come off a little fancy for
the office.
For like every day. Okay. But you know what? Maybe you a fancy person. Mm. So, I mean, you do you.
You will smell different than everybody else wearing that fragrance, I'll tell you that.
For sure.
Not everybody's going to have a rose fragrance on at work.
And I feel like this is a very lovely, unique smell.
Yeah, I think it's something easy, different than most people. I don't have a lot of rose fragrances in my collection. I will say this. There's other fragrances that kind of smell somewhat like this, but it's not the same, which I'll touch on in my final thoughts. But at the end of the day, I do like this one, and Kelly likes it too. So I think a man or girl could wear. I think it depends on the person and what their type is. If you're a man and you don't like rose fragrances, then this is a no-brainer. You're not going to buy it or pick it up. But if you're a man, you like rose, you like oud, you like different type of fragrances, then definitely check it out. Ratings and final thoughts. Okay, so I'm going to give my rating first and Kelly gives hers. If you're new to this channel, basically we rate it from 1 to 10. I talk about the performance with the score and the price tag and if it's worth it or not. So my rating, I'm going to give it a 7 out of 10. I'm going to give it 7 out of 10 because the price of $145 is a lot. And a lot of people say that that's like designer prices, why you want to buy niche. But this is different than your typical fragrances at Macy's and Sephora.
Isn't
and somebody wants to smell different.
More expensive niche, than designer?
Yeah. But if you look at Dior Sauvage, if you want the Dior Sauvage EDP or Parfum, you're looking at about $120 to $150 a bottle. This is $145, so it's pushing that price almost.
Niche.
Yeah, so I think you should...
You pay more for niche.
I think you should definitely check it out. If you want something different, you want to smell different than everybody else at work. People wear designer fragrances.
Okay.
It is expensive hobby. She can vouch for that for my fragrance collection in our bedroom. Nevertheless, I'm going to give it some more points because a lot of guys may not feel like the rose is something that they want to wear. It's not like a masculine scent, so I understand that. But not every fragrance has to be masculine. Wear a fragrance that you like. That's all that matters at the end of the day. You smell good and people like it, just wear the fragrance. But I'm going to give it a couple points deducted because of that and the price point. And everybody's performance on skin will be different. Mine's 7 to 8 hours. You might get more, you might get less. So it's going to factor on your skin. So I'm not going to give it a perfect 10 because $145 is a lot for anybody to buy a fragrance, designer or niche. If you don't have the money.
Yes. I'm just saying, y'all don't go to colognes. And it like, I mean, obviously, I know you make the, like, people seek out cheap ones because
affordable,
hey,
yeah.
We all don't have
the money to buy, yeah, definitely.
We ain't got money like that, but we still enjoy the things that we enjoy. And that doesn't mean that we're not allowed to have things that we enjoy because we can't afford them. But if you want good stuff, you gotta pay for it. And this kind of shit lasts forever. It's how long? Oh my God. Well, first of all, if you're a collector like Chris,
you have a lot of fragrances. You're not gonna go through every bottle.
You're never gonna go through a fucking bottle. So, sorry.
You can wear it a few times, so enjoy it.
Yeah, so like, I mean, sometimes he'll like resell his bottles like after he's like, okay, I've run my course with this fragrance.
I'll trade or swap it if I can. I'll get something else. But I mean, it depends. If you like rose fragrance, I think you're going to enjoy this one a lot. If you don't, then
and certain things are going to stay in his collection forever. Yeah. And I mean, that's just going to be, it's going to be years before he empties out those bottles. Yeah. And that's fine. Which I think they're investments. But when you have a smaller collection, of course, like his brother actually empties out
All his bottles.
His bottles. But he only has maybe two or three.
Yeah, he don't have many, no. Under so five.
That, yeah, that makes sense. Whereas Chris has, I don't even know how many.
I have enough probably to wear one probably for every month or every day of the year probably for a good... For a good year, I have enough fragrance.
I think you could wear a different one every week.
Yeah, probably too. I have a lot, which is just
plus
I get other stuff coming in the mail and stuff.
More than 52.
Yeah, more than 50 some fragrances. I lost count because I always get fragrances in or stuff. Companies send me stuff, or I get stuff from friends to borrow.
Including
so.
Samples and stuff like that. It's a lot.
I think this is a great release. If you have this type of money, you should definitely check it out if you want to smell different. Because a lot of people wear the same designer fragrances to work, hanging out, whatever. And sometimes you want to smell different. At the end of the day, you want to smell like somebody else, not the same person around you.
I would rate this a 9.
Okay. You rate 9? Okay. So do you feel like it's more of a male fragrance or a female fragrance in the middle? How do you feel about it?
I
know you do like it for yourself to wear.
I love the mind of, Steven... And, I forget his name, but a lot of the fragrance reviewers that you watch, that all fragrances are unisex. Mm. That's just where I stand. I can, some people are very much more into the gender of things.
Yeah, they want to label everything. It is what it is. Like I said, fragrance is like, you just wear it and you enjoy it. It doesn't matter if it's a male or female.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, at the end of the day, that's it.
Put gender on a smell, but whatever.
Final thoughts. So this fragrance to me, it's not the same, but it has the same feel to it. I feel as the other fragrance that you like, Annouunced Parfums de Marly, I would say Delina, because that has rose in it too. So it kind of has that feel, but it's not Delina. I'm saying is if you like Delina, you're going to like this. If you like Atomic Rose Initial, you're going to like this because it has that rosy feel, but it's not.
Oh, is this why I like this one so much?
So it's not, if you have Delina, that's a good fragrance. It has similarities to this, but it's not the exact same fragrance because those fragrances didn't have oud in it. But this is a great fragrance along with that one. So if you like that one, you're going to like this one. Yeah, it's nice. And if you're running out of juice in that one, definitely check this one out.
Of course, Delina is definitely marketed towards women.
With the beautiful bottle presentation. Well, but I think that's a little bit more of mine. I think that's $300 for a bottle. This is $145. Oh. So it's about half the price of that and half the price of Initio Atomic Rose too. So it's one of those things where it's like you have to pick which one you like.
So in that way, it's a bargain.
It's half the price of those two. And like you say, the performance are all good, all three of them.
That's what I'm saying. So like when you're like, oh, it's like designer prices, I'm like, excuse me, niche can be like 300 something. Yeah. I don't know why people be complaining. It's expensive.
Yeah, designers and niche are both expensive, but when you step into niche girl, you look this niche game looking at $200, $300 a bottle, it's expensive. You won't smell like anybody else that's out walking in the streets majority of the time. It's going to be that 1%, maybe 5% chance of smelling like somebody else with niche fragrance, but not really, because the prices are really high and a lot of people are not going to go out of their way to buy those fragrances without smelling them. Thank you, George, for sending me this product for review. I really appreciate it. Me and my girlfriend both like it, so we give our thumb approval to definitely check it out. See if you can get samples. They might offer samples down the road, I'm not sure, but heck, for the $36 a month to make your four payments, that's not bad too. So I'll leave a link down below to his website and you can look at it and fill it out. I've never done it before, but I've heard it's very easy and there's no interest fees.
When I've done that stuff, it's so easy. I mean, it just automatically is going to charge your card or your debit card or your account or whatever.
I think it's like every 2 weeks, they said.
Yeah, and I was like, at least for me, I get paid every 2 weeks. So it was like, I got paid. And that money came out, and that was, that worked out well. And I guess it's like just like it depends on the timing of when you buy it. So make sure like you buy when you on the week.
Yeah, because they take out the first payment when you order the day. They take out that first payment that day. So keep that in mind. You got to charge.
They're going to tell you exactly the dates that they're going to take it out, and they even like at least when I did like Afterpay, they'll email you and remind you.
That's what I've heard.
We're taking out
notification.
A payment. Make sure you got money in your account if you're like a paycheck to paycheck person.
Thanks for watching another fragrance video. If you like fragrance content like this, make sure you show your support by clicking that red subscribe button down below. If you're new to the channel, you haven't subscribed yet, I appreciate that. Make sure you like the video if you like this type of content, and make sure you click the bell icon. Future videos and giveaway announcements as well. Thanks for being on the video, Kelly.
Of course.
You guys take care. Be safe. We care about every single one of you. We'll see you next video. Peace.
Bye.